Good morning and welcome to today's assembly on the 15th of March. I'm delighted to say that we have only 1 week to go before we have all of our year 12, 13 and 14 pupils back in school, and we're really looking forward to welcoming you next Monday. One of the programmes that I have really enjoyed during lockdown is Grayson's Art Club. If any of you haven't seen it, it's a show which celebrates art, from famous artists to celebrities to the general public, who send in their artworks every week based on a theme, for example, nature, family or food. The benefits of art are well known. It opens the heart and mind to possibilities and fuels the imagination. Art is a process of learning to create and experience the world in new ways. It also makes you more observant. Creating art helps you learn to see by concentrating on detail and paying more attention to your environment. Art can also improve our mental health. Painting, sculpting, drawing and photography are relaxing and rewarding hobbies that can lower your anxiety and lead to an overall improvement in well-being. Creating art can take your mind off life's many stresses, at least momentarily. It clears some headspace and allows you to focus on the good in life. Many artists, through their work, provide a commentary on society. In Grayson's Art Club, the participants have used art to tell their stories of living through a pandemic. This is not a new phenomenon. In the 20th century, Pablo Picasso famously reflected the horrors and pain of war in his brilliant painting Guernica. And Mexican artist Frida Kahlo explored issues of gender and identity through her work. More recently, Steve McQueen has explored race in the UK, and Chinese contemporary artist Ai Weiwei has challenged his government's stance on democracy and human rights. He claims, if anything, art is about morals, about our belief in humanity. Without that, there simply is no art. This quotation really links to what I enjoy most about the TV show Grayson's Art Club. It is the people who feature and how Grayson Perry relates to them. The astounding degree and amount of talent out there is given its due, and Grayson's interviewing and listening skills, always alert, always interested, never judgmental, draw out the stories behind every work. We meet various people, many of whom have been struggling and face a variety of challenges in their lives. For example, Emma, who refuses to let her sight loss prevent her from making art. There's Alex, a vulnerable young man who makes clay models to help with the loss of routine in lockdown. And Chloe, whose work commemorates her father, who sadly passed away in November. All of these conversations are characterised by empathy, and all have been made possible because of art. To my mind, being empathetic or empathic is one of the most important virtues that we can cultivate. If we practice this, we can aim to see the world as others see it, to walk in their shoes. Empathy helps us cooperate with others, build friendships, make moral decisions, and intervene when we see people being bullied. Recently, the phrase radical empathy has been coined. This is moving beyond the conventional ideas of empathy to take actions that will not only help others, but will also improve our society. Practicing radical empathy can provide real change in people's lives and help us challenge inequalities and social injustice, examples of which are plentiful in society today. For Quakers, empathy is vital, as we read in Quaker faith and practice. Sometimes the need will be for patient understanding, sometimes for practical help, sometimes for challenge and encouragement. But we cannot be aware of each other's needs unless we know each other. Philosopher and Quaker John McMurray puts it more succinctly: there is no I without a you. The importance of taking time for others and being empathetic should be a priority for all of us, especially as we think about coming back to school and socialising more with our friends and classmates. Let us think about that as we have our silence, after which we are going to see some of the excellent artwork from Key Stage 3 that has been submitted during this period of remote learning.
Hello, I'm Bob Ross, and I'd like to welcome you to the 24th Joy of Painting series. If this is your first time with us, please allow me to extend a personal invitation for you to drag out your brushes and some paints and paint along with us each show. And if you've been with us before, allow me to thank you for inviting us back for another series of painting shows. Tell you what, let's get started today and have them run all the colors across the screen that you need to paint along with us at home. And while they're doing that, let me show you what I've got up here.
On this canvas, you're the creator. Anything that you want, you can build here. This is your world. Your dreams come real here. Well, be honest, I'm a nature freak. I love to walk through the woods and talk to the animals. Don't tell anybody that. I even talk to trees at times. But you need to understand nature to appreciate the great, great things that have been created. We spend so much of our life walking around looking, but never seeing. And if painting teaches you nothing else, it'll teach you to see nature, to appreciate some of the beauty that's around us every day that we take for granted.
Just a gorgeous little painting. All right, this is where the fun starts.
I think sometimes we work too hard at painting. Painting should always be fun. Should make you happy. That's when you're truly an artist. You know, when we do these paintings, we have a general idea of what we're going to do, but other than that, they're really not planned. We learn to work with what happens. And when you're at home, don't worry about following exactly what we have here. Let things happen and use what happens and create your own masterpieces. Don't just try to copy what we're doing. And you can do it. Because this is your world and you can create anything that you want in it. Blue, brown, little touch of crimson. And just let the brush just sort of bounce around and play and just let it have fun. This piece of canvas is your world.
Phthalo blue, a little bit of phthalo blue. And just work it into the bristle.
There we go. Just let these big old clouds just float around the sky and have fun. Clouds are about the freest thing in nature. Let's just put a happy little sky up here. Just make it a little crisscross stroke. That's all there is to it. Have a super day. We look forward to seeing you again. Bye-bye.